saddens my heart to see that in the land of plenty, Aotearoa New Zealand, our people struggle. Home ownership is out of reach and housing is unaffordable. So what I would like to talk to you all about today is papakaima, an intentional community with the aspect of collective living and the ability for it to have impact on you and the others you care about most. But first you might be thinking, what is papakaima and what is it about? Well, papakaima is ideal. Papakaima is functional, intentional, intergenerational, and typically built on ancestral Māori land. Papakaima is based on Māori principles such as kaitiakitanga and manaakitanga, guardianship and respect. But these are concepts that anybody can adapt with their own beliefs, principles, or in general, what is most important for them. Papakaima also reflects the family support system, or whānau support system. They are homes that are built using imagination, dreams, and wish fulfillments. They are more than just physical structures. They provide whānau the opportunity to bond closer with each other. They also provide whānau the opportunity to revitalise and reinforce cultural and spiritual aspects, such as tikanga or te reo Māori. And it just so happens that this is helping our whānau out of a housing crisis too. My whānau and I live on our very own papakaima at Kōhu Pātiki, named the Aroha Te Rangi Kāna Whenua, named after my great-great-grandfather, Aroha Te Rangi Robin. Now when the COVID-19 pandemic hit Aotearoa last year, my whānau and I felt we could not have been in a more safer place. We kept to our bubbles, we were close enough to stand on our balconies, wave to our neighbours and see if they were okay. We didn't feel isolated or alone. We had a mother kai garden which flourished with fruits and vegetables and sustained us through the remainder of the lockdown. Even our kaumātua became experts in Zoom. FYI, it was not easy trying to teach them how to use Zoom. Sadly though, we did attend our first tangihanga, or funeral, via Zoom too. Side note, this was the first funeral I've ever been to that finished on time with no dishes after the haka. Now, my mum would order everybody shopping, have it delivered to our house, and as whānau, we would unpack it, sanitise it, repackage it, and with PPE gear, I would deliver it to everybody's doorstep. Now that is what papakaima is about. It is about taking care of each other, especially your whānau. Did you know it is more cost-effective to live as a papakaima? The papakaima are built on one title, which means you only get one set of rates. Papakaima also shares a bespoke or different communal infrastructure system. Most papakaima in Hawke's Bay have a communal space, such as a barbecue, where whānau can gather, hui, and eat together. Our whānau also has a system where our rubbish is collected every Thursday and our lawns mowed every fortnight. This service is shared evenly amongst the five papakaima homes that are on our whenua via the weekly service fee, which is a fee that is managed by our papakaima trust, who oversee all the expenses and revenue that go out and in of our papakaima, such as maintenance, or maintenance that might be needed on a home. We attract an economy of scale because we seek services on behalf of a collective. Perhaps long gone are the days of the white picket fences and quarter acre section papakaima. Albeit an old traditional Māori way of living, perhaps it is the future. Modernised and loaded with potential, the potential to gain economic and cultural wealth. Economic and cultural wealth. For example, my auntie, Pania, started her own clothing brand out of her shed at our papakaima. This clothing brand is called Noku. Some of you may or may not have heard of it. But her business is thriving so well that she has had to move her business to a bigger premises where it can thrive even more. This goes back to a point that I'd like to make. Papakaima is a life force. It is a place of connection. It is a place of healing, and as a place where an individual can grow, especially as whānau. Papa Kāinga is your next step towards achieving your aspirations, but it is self-determined by you, and you only. Embrace Papa Kāinga and you will thrive too. I am Haile Siloata. Tēnā koutou kākou. Thank you all for listening.
Oh, Rocky! Oh, fuck!